many people will have heard of Henry Moore, perhaps Barbara Hepworth. Elizabeth Frink really is considered in that field as well as one of the most significant British artists of the period working in sculpture.
Elizabeth Frink was born in the Suffolk village of Great Thurlow. Her father was in the army, and her work was heavily influenced by the Second World War. Her first major exhibition came in 1952, when she was still at Chelsea Art School.
I don't like reality in art. I have reality enough when I'm outside. I want to create my own fantastic forms based on my observation of human and animal forms.
In the 1960s, Elizabeth Frink created these huge bronze heads.
She wanted to explore the idea of the sort of polar extremes of human behaviour. So we have one set we're standing beside here, which, known as the goggle heads, really represent the sort of purveyors of evil, the aggressor. And then behind me, just here, there's a second series that she made slightly later that she called the tribute heads. And they were really, again, exploring the victims of war.
There are 90 pieces by Frink in the exhibition.
This is one of my favourite pieces. It's called The Dying King. It could easily be Richard III. Frink said she'd been influenced by Laurence Olivier's performance in the film. Look up here, quite brutal. Could easily be a sword cut, couldn't it?
The Riachi warriors are another highlight. Huge, menacing. What are they doing? What are they thinking? It's not all menace, though. In The Running Man, the experts see a symbol of human perseverance and hope.